So now we're going to have two nonlinear equations. One's going to be a circle and one's going to be an ellipse. We're fairly familiar with a circle like that. An ellipse is an oval shape. Not like that, but you know, pretend like I can draw. Okay, it's an oval shape, and we're going to graph both of those in chapter 8. So right now, we're just kind of have a rough sketch. Okay, so when we have a circle and an ellipse, there are five possibilities. You could have a circle, and then the ellipse could be just little inside, and it could be the other way, the ellipse could be on the outside, but there's going to be no solution here because they don't intersect anyplace. You could have a circle, and then the ellipse could be like that, where it's tangent to the circle. And so they only share one point, so there is one solution. You could have a circle, and the ellipse can intersect like that, where it intersects in two points, and we have two solutions. You could have a circle. Well, that looks more like an ellipse, but pretend this is a circle. And the ellipse could go something like that, where it's tangent right here, and then it intersects in two other points. That, in that case, there are three solutions. And you could have a circle. Oh, that one was going good, but oh well. And then an ellipse that goes something like that, where it intersects in four places, and there are four solutions. So those are the possibilities for a system that has a circle and an ellipse. So now here we have a system, and what we're going to do is we're going to use the elimination by addition method, because you can see I've got x squareds and y squareds and constants lined up. If I could just multiply that top equation by -3, I could add it to the bottom equation and the x squared term would drop out. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to have -3x² - 3y² = -78. And then I just copy down the bottom equation. When I add these two equations, these drop out, which we thought that was going to happen. That was our plan. They canceled out. And so we get 22y² = 22. If I divide both sides by 22, I get y² = 1. And then I have to solve for y, I have to take the square root of both sides. But when I take the square root of both sides, I have to consider plus or minus. And so I get y = + or - 1. Okay, let's take the positive one first. So our equation, don't want to scroll back up, so I'm just going to write it again. It was x² + y² = 26. Okay, if I put in a positive 1, okay, so let's let y equal 1. I get x² + 1² = 26, or x² + 1 = 26, or x² = 25. But here again, I have to take the square root of both sides, and when I do that, I'm going to have a plus or minus. So I'm putting like the square root function on, and I have to say x = + or - 5. Now, what that means is when I put in a 1 for y, I got two solutions for x. So there are two ordered pairs here. -5, 1, that's a solution, and +5, 1 is a solution, okay? That's just if I put in the 1. What if I let y = -1? Because remember, I had two choices over here, +1 or -1. Well, if I put in a -1, it looks like this. But when I square a -1, I get 1 again. So you can see it's matching, it's matching to that line. So you're going to get the same two solutions. x = + or - 5. You know, subtract 1 and take the square root. Okay, I'll scroll a little bit. Okay, that gives me two more solutions then. I could have -5, -1, Or put and positive 5, negative 1. So those points are all solutions. Okay, so let's see what the graph looks like. Well, I could graph all my solutions. I had negative 5, 1. That's a solution. 5, 1. And then I had negative 5, negative 1. And 5, negative 1. Okay, so somewhere there's an ellipse that's doing this kind of thing, kind of that thing. Okay, probably not quite like that. All right, what about the circle? Well, to graph the circle, I would have to know the square root of 26, which we haven't talked about graphing these, but the square root of 26 is just over 5. So my circle's going to go through points like this. So it's going to be a circle going well, not like that, but it would be a circle. And then you can see that the points, see, it should have gone through those two points. I was off when I was drawing it. Okay, but this is easier for me to do on the board, but that's what's happening. So it intersects in four places. We have four solutions. And it's all those ordered pairs. And you would just list the solutions, negative 5, negative 1. I don't know how you want to list them, but it doesn't really matter. Negative 5, positive 1, negative 5. Oh, sorry. I did the two negative 5 ones. So positive 5, negative 1, and positive 5, positive 1. But those are the solutions. Okay.